shake me again. I hope that you have been the kind of person you really are now. I'll be so good. Oh, I wish I could get the message over to you.
Pop-Tart, spring cheese, juice, fruit, and milk. Lunch today is beef, shepherd's pie, casserole, dinner roll, fruit, milk, and pudding. Congratulations to no one. College visiting, Sauk Valley Community College on 10-11, Educators of Beauty on 10-18, and Eureka College on 10-24. Please pick up a form in the office to meet with these reps. Seniors, you can start filling out your FAFSA form as of October 1st. Please do not delay in doing so as the grant money runs out quickly. If you're going to any type of education after high school, you must complete a FAFSA form. If you're interested in attending Theater Fest at the Drama Club this January, all forms are due today, which I think means yesterday. Please pick up one for Ms. Berglund if you've not already! Exclamation point. Attention seniors and juniors, Morrison High School's prom committee will meet Mr. Bartow's class in room 6 today. I believe that was yesterday, but it could be today. During homeroom, discuss and select the theme for Morrison High School's 2020 prom. The prom will be held on Saturday, April 25th, 2020 at Deer Valley Golf Club. All interested juniors and seniors are welcome to offer their input and vote on the theme during Tuesday's meeting. So no, that's today. There'll be a boys' basketball meeting today during homeroom in the cafeteria. Boys' basketball is looking for 2 students to video games and help out with different things. Please come to the office for more information. All girls interested in playing girls' basketball this year should attend the players' meeting during homeroom on Friday, October 11th at the chemistry lab. Happy birthday yesterday to Bradley Topper, and happy birthday today to Caleb Unger! Don't forget to stop in the Bi-County room and pick up your free DQ treat. So it's only for birthday people. That makes sense, okay? Caleb Unger, how many Ungers are there?
What?
Okay, at least 3. Okay. Quote of the week. If you have the chance to make people happy, just do it. Sometimes people are struggling silently. Maybe your act of kindness can make their day. I'm gonna change one of these ones. I really am. It is, because it's the quote of the week. It's quote of the week, Bailey. Welcome to class. Looking very cozy today.
Okay,
Nothing wrong with that.
No, I didn't get that. I've had
comments
on my outfit 5 times today.
Yeah, I meant it positively.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Because I'm
wearing
1:30 and people don't
call
me before this.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bailey. I mean it sincerely.
Nelly didn't go to swimming today.
Pulls out the inhaler. Wow. Nelly, the more I learn about you, the more and more of a nerd you really are. All right. Kid with asthma joins swim team. Have death wish? Question mark.
What? Yes, you may, just not in here. Oh, whoa. That was unexpected. All right.
Tell me why. These numbers don't belong. Wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, 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 Mom, wow. I hate this class. All right. So, tell me which number doesn't belong and why. Give me one of them. Go. Quinn.
17, because it has an odd tens.
Ooh, so it's the only one with an odd in the tens place. I still don't know whether that's possessive or not. Or it's just plural. I'm going to go with plural. Maybe it's plural possessive. People. That's one for 17. Bailey! Everyone always says that. But isn't 17 the only one divisible by 17? Isn't 20? I mean, why is 5 special?
Because it is.
Okay. I think it's pretty arbitrary. It's like the only one that 65 is the only one that is called 65. So it's different than all the rest. But valid enough. Valid enough. You're valid. Okay? Give me some myrrh. Which is what I feel like Jesus said at the, you know, at his birth. Give me some myrrh. He can talk. That's not all he can do. What? Repeating digits. Go ahead, go again.
I have another one for 65.
All right, more 65.
It's the only one that's two digits, don't
have it. Ooh. Let's check it out. 1 and 7, 2 and 6, 4 and 4. I'll add 8, 6 and 5 adds to 11. I always like checking the digits, right? No one has a 1 for 26, huh? Told you it's a tough one, yeah.
26
is the only number with 2 in it. I feel like, well, yeah, you're one to talk, okay? Like, well, that's only one's divisible by 5, right? I mean, sure, man. Like, all numbers are going to have a unique factorization, you know what I mean? Every number is a unique set of factors, right? So, in theory, all are different. This guy is just playing honest. He's just like, yeah, it's the only one that has a 2 in it. He's right. Is that unique? No, not really, but it's true. I'm not going to write it down, though. I'm also going to do this because Bailey's a jerk. Wow. Terrible human being. It's not a reason anymore, Bailey. It's not valid. You're not valid. That's what I'm trying to say. Hi, Marissa. Welcome back. A lot's happened since you've been gone. Nothing new, just Bailey being Bailey. All right. I don't know. I think you're fine. You're fine. You didn't break the chair. I like your glasses.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Ellie! Got anything for us? Other than candy? Come on. Nothing? Yes, ma'am. Yep, 17 is the only prime number. Cool. Yep, repeating digits. Yep. Already got it. I've been showing everybody else this today. It's not great, but I'm going to show it because I think it's good to know. It seems like you guys are running out of ways to look at numbers. Yeah. No. Yeah, sure, why not? I don't care. No! Is this the class we talked about the jewel pods in? Okay, never mind. It was a joke. I know. Everything. Yes, you can. That was a joke.
Wow, that is the weirdest.
Like, when I think of weird things, I always have to be like, well, it's not that weird because the girls' bathroom on one floor is over there and the other girls, right? And then I remind myself, life is just really boring.
And then I walked into the boys' bathroom almost half the time. And he's
reading is hard. All right. So, you ever heard of binary? Of course you have. Binary. Oftentimes, when a choice is presented to you, it's presented a binary, yes or no, right? And oftentimes, that is a false binary or a false dichotomy because really yes or no is not the only option. Always look out for false dichotomies. Doesn't have to be one or the other. It could be both. ¿Por qué no las dos? Right? Soft shell, hard shell? Why not both?
I do too.
All right. So let's talk about binary and numbers. So we are in a decimal system, tens, right? After we do 9 numbers, the 10th number carries over. That's a 10 system, right? We used to be on a 12 system. That's why we have things like the clock that are still on 12. That's why we have words like a dozen and words like a gross, meaning 144. 12 was what we used for a long time because it made sense, actually. It makes more sense than 10 because if you buy 12 muffins, You can divide it among three people evenly. You can divide it among four people evenly. Six people, two people, right? If you buy 10 muffins, well, it's either you and another person or five friends. Otherwise, you're cutting muffins in half for everybody, right? So 12 makes sense. It's a pretty divisible number. That's not too big. But now we're on base 10, decimal, okay? But you can do other bases, meaning that after you get to a certain point, you carry the number over. So a binary base means after we get to 1, we carry over for the 2. Binary meaning 2. So if we were to write these numbers in binary, let's check that out. Let's write 65 in binary. Before we do that, let's start with the basic numbers. What's 1 in binary? Well, it's 1. 2 in binary. Well, we'd like to put a 2 there, but we can't, right? We have to carry over it 2. That's what binary means, right? Decimal means 10 because dec is 10, right? Because December is the 10th month of the year. So 1 is there. We want to add a 1 here, but we can't. We have to carry it over. So we get this. Okay? For 3, well, we have a spot to put a 1. So I do. 2 ones, just like we would for 10, 11, right? There's a spot there. Now, for 4, I try to put a 1 here, and I got to carry over, right? Which means I have to carry over there. So I end up with 1, 0, 0. You don't get it? Okay, I'll start over in a second. 5, on the other hand, see how we're at 4? We have a spot where we can put a 1, right? So I'm going to put a 1 there. That's how you write 5 in binary. 6, I want to put a 1 here, right? But I can't, so I have to carry over. 1, 1, 0, right? I add 1 here and it carries over, right? Think about 9, how we carry that over. We don't keep the 9. It carries over and turns into a 1, 0. We want to add a 1 here, but we have to carry over, so it turns into a 1, 0. 7, well, we have room for it, triple 1. 8, on the other hand, we put a 1 here and it carries over, right? Put a 1 here, it carries over, carries over. We got to get a fourth place. So that's up to 8 in binary. Let's start over. Eyes up here, please. 1 is 1. We're in binary, so after we get to 1, we carry over for the 2. So I want to put a 1 here and add on to it, but I can't, right? Because that would require a 2, and I'm not allowed to write the number 2. Just like in 10, we're not allowed to write the number 10 in a single-digit space, right? We have to carry over. So I have to carry over that 1, and there's a 0 in its place. For 3, I can put a 1 there, no big deal, right? But now for 4, I have to put a 1 here. It's going to carry over, and I get a 1 here with zeros in their place. For 5, I can just put a 1 there. For 6, if I put a 1 there, it has to carry over with a 0 in its place. For 7, well, I can just put a 1 there. For 8, though, if I put a 1 here, it carries over, and zeros in their place. Are you feeling a little bit better now? Just a little bit? Not better at all? Okay. I'm going to do these, and I think it'll help. Another way to think of this, okay, is in tens counting, right, decimal system, the first column is the ones column, right? That's what we call it. Really, it's the 10 to the zeroth column. 10 to the zeroth is 1. So anything you put here is telling me how many ones you want. You want 9 ones? Well, then put a 9 there, right? That makes sense. The next column is the 10 to the first column, or the tens column, right? It tells you how many tens you want. Well, if you want 2 tens, put a 2 there. That's 20, right? 2 tens and 5 ones is 25. So I want 2 of these guys and 5 of those. 2 tens, 5 ones, that's 25. 10 squared is 100, right? So we have the hundreds column. Tell me how many hundreds you want, you put that there. Tell me how many tens want, how many ones you want. You can write any number this way, right? That's not shocking. For binary, instead of tens, we're dealing with twos. So we have 2 to the zeroth power. What's 2 to the zeroth? It's 1. 2 to the first, what's that? 2. So in this column, you're saying, how many 1s do you want? In this column, you're saying, how many 2s do you want? Here, we have 2 squared, which is 4. So you tell me how many 4s you want. It's almost like $4 bills. Like, I can give you 4s, I can give you 2s, I can give you 1s, right? 2 cubed is 8, so we have $8 bills that we can give you as well. Now check it out. If I wanted $8, I could write 2 4s, right? Give me 2 4s. But that's silly, right? Just give me 1 8. So that's why we don't ever have a 2 in binary. We don't need it, because whenever you write a 2, you could have written a 1 here. Right? If I write a 2 underneath the 2, that's 2 2s. Well, I could have just written for 1 4. You dig? Now, Next up is 2 to the 4th. Well, that's 16. So again, I could write 2 8s here, but that'd be silly, so that's why we carry it over. It's just 1 16. Okay. So let's write 65. We're going to need 2 to the 6th, 2 to the 5th, 2 to the 4th, 2 cubed, 2 squared, 2 to the 1st, 2 to the 0th. We already talked about these guys, that 2 to the 0th is 1. Right, so that's our 1's column, there's our 2's column, our 4's column, our 8's column, our 16's column, our 32nd's column, and our 64's column. 65 is very easy to write in binary. Yes, ma'am?
Can I go to the restaurant now?
Yes, you may.
Thank you.
What's the biggest bill we can give somebody if we want to do 65? Without busting.
60.
Yeah, we can give them a 64, right? Can I give them a 32 on top of that? No, because then they got to give me change back. How about a 16? No, because that'd be too much. 16 and 64 is way bigger than 65. In fact, we have zeros for all these other ones, except for 1, 1. So that's the binary version of 65. 164 and 1, 1. Here's a $64 bill, here's a $1 bill, you've got yourself a 65. I don't give you anything else here. Make it a little more sense? Yes, ma'am. It's a different way to look at numbers, and you guys are kind of running out of ways to do it. Also, if a number has a certain property, right, which is what we're listing here, if that pops up in binary or ternary or as any base 10 or whatever we want to use, any base, then it must be inherent to that number and not just a coincidence because we're happen to be counting by tens, right? So that's a way people check with number theory. Does 3 have a special property, or is it just because we write it in base 10 that it has a special property? So that's 65. What's 44? Well, we can't give ourselves a 64, right? That'd be way too big. But we can give ourselves a 32. So 132. How much more do we need to get to 44? 12, right? So we're not going to give ourselves a 16. We can give ourselves an 8. How much more to get to 44? 4 more. So 4. There's the binary for 44. 101100. Talk like a robot. I have a song for you. Twenty-six. Because Bailey wants to know, why is this relevant? 26 in binary. What's the biggest number we can put a 1 in front of? Hannah.
16.
All right, a 16. Landry, we're at 16. Can we put a 1 in front of the 8?
Yeah.
That'll give us 24, right? 4 more or no?
No.
Too many. 2. Nothing. That's 26. 1, 16, 1, 8. No 4s. 1, 2. No 1. 16 plus 8 plus 2, 26. Landry. What's the biggest number I can give myself for 17? Here are my options. 2. Well, I can't give myself a 64. That'd be too big, right? Can't give myself a 32. Can I give myself a 16? Yeah, that'll fit, right? How much is left over after I've given myself a 16? Just 1, right? So here's our 1s. I need 1, 1. It's like when you're playing Monopoly, right? I need $56. Give me a 50, a 5, and a 1. Well, give me a 16 and a 1, and I've got 17. It's just not base 10, right? It's base 2, so our options are powers of 2. 1, 2, 4, 6. I'm sorry, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. And so on and so forth. What do you notice about their binary forms? What makes 26 different? Hannah.
It has one of the 2 to the power of 1.
Mm-hmm. It's the only one with a digit in the 2's column. It's not the 10's column, right? It's the 2's column. So that's unique. What else do you notice about it? Yes. Sixty-five's got a lot of zeros. It's a palindrome. It's a Hannah. Do you guys know what a palindrome is? It means the same forward and backwards. Race car is another example. Hannah. 1000001. 65 is an example. 10001 is a palindrome. 17. But 26 and 44 aren't. How many zeros are in 65 written as binary? More zeros than ones, right? What about 44? Same number, right? What about 17? More zeros than ones. 26 is the only one that has more ones than zeros. Sorry, I'm mocking one of my students. Guess which one it is. No, it's not Bailey. Guess again. You're right. Put that away. So you should have something like this to get out. Two parallel lines. We don't guess they're parallel, they tell us they are. That's what the parallel symbol is right there on a diagram. They're both running in the same direction. Crouching tiger, hidden dragon. And I believe, and I'm going to be wrong because every class period I've been wrong, that I numbered my angles like this. I did it! Yay! Last class I did do it the right way. This is the way I always do it, except for apparently my first three classes yesterday. All right, so we learned about corresponding angles. Remember, it's the same relative position, not the same position. That would get messy. We've seen what that looks like in that spoopy video. Give me some examples of corresponding angles. Yeah, based on this diagram. Like, for instance, angle 1 and what other angle are corresponding? 1 and what? Nope, not corresponding. What does it mean to be corresponding? Same relative position. What? Not 1 and 8. Mm-mm. Closer, though. What it means is that you look at the intersection, top left corner here is going to be corresponding with the top left corner here. They're in the same relative spot, right? They're both relatively in the same spot. They're not in the same spot, but they are both in the top left corner of their own respective intersections. So angle 1 and angle 5 are going to be corresponding. Quinn, angle 2 corresponds with what angle on my diagram? Oh, geez, you guys can't see this stuff. Would you guys tell me? Angle 6. Very good, because they're both in the top right corner of their intersections. They're relatively in the same spot. Angle 3, Ellie, corresponds with what? Angle 3 corresponds with what angle down here?
7.
Is it hard to see? Okay, I'm just concerned because, like, you have glasses. Okay, I was just thinking, man, like, what am I going to do if it is actually hard to see from back there for, like, normal people? And I put that in heavy quotations. Marissa, angle 4 corresponds with what angle? Angle 8, because they're both in the bottom left corner. Very good. ESPN 8, the Ocho. Cool. Let's talk about other angles. How about linear pairs? Oh, no! I know what you're thinking. Why would he write in yellow? It's Macy's favorite color, that's why. All right. All right. So, linear pair. Give me examples of angles that are a linear pair. Mark.
1 and 2.
1 and 2. Because they're two angles on a line. Linear pair. Now, I know you want to say collinear. Let me explain why that's not as good. 1, 2, 3, and 4 are all collinear, yeah? They're all on the same line. They are not a linear pair, though. A linear pair is when there's only two angles on a line. Because linear pairs are always supplementary. Are 1 and 2 supplementary here? No. So linear pair theorem doesn't apply. Because they're not a linear pair. This is a linear pair. Only two angles on a line. Aw, man. No look fadeaway. Emphasis on the fadeaway. We also know that angle 2 and angle 3 are a linear pair, right? And 3 and 4 and 4 and 1 and on and on and on and on and on, right? Cool. Here's the rule. If they're a linear pair, we don't call them anything else. Okay? We're going to have some definitions that come up, and they're going to be like, wait a minute. Don't these guys also fit that definition? And be like, no. 1 and 2 are a linear pair. Okay? So let's talk about those definitions. How about alternate interior angles. Alright. So the interior is the inside. Right? We talked about that last time. Inside the parallels. You know, like my air horn? Then get me a soundboard. Ungrateful pieces of slime. Natalie's not here today. This is sad. Shout out to Natalie. She's probably watching at home. Leave a comment. Like and subscribe. Clout for clout. Pray for Natalie. Hashtag pray for Natalie. I am concerned. It's 2 days in a row. Natalie, I hope you're okay, because I'm not! I love how we're like almost 3:45 and I can just yell randomly and none of you guys are surprised. Thank you. Thank you for accepting me. No, Bailey. No. Stop. Calvin. We need angles that are alternate, meaning they're on opposite sides of the transversal. This is our transversal. And are in the interior. So our only options for the interior are 4, 3, 5, 6. Which ones of those are going to be alternate angles? So here are your options. Give me two that are on opposite sides of the transversal. Give him a hint. Give him a hint.
Oh, 3 and 5.
Ah, that's not a hint. 3 and 5 are alternate interior angles, so Calvin. What's the other set of alternate interior angles here? Say again. 3 and 5. 1 and 7 are exterior. They're on the outside. We need stuff that's on the inside. So 3 and 5. What else? 6 and 4. Now you might say, wait a minute, aren't 4 and 3 on opposite sides and in the interior? Yes, yes they are. Yes, indeed. But we're gonna call those a linear pair. Yes, indeed. So that's the alternate interior angles. Unsuspecting. Really, they shouldn't be. But they are every time. Let's talk about same side interior angles. Marissa,
yeah.
I need angles that are on the same side and in the interior.
3 and 6.
3 and 6. Ellie, same side and in the interior. No. Same side and in the interior. We already said 3 and 6.
4 and 5.
Thank you. No laughing in math class. That's what I'm talking about. Instant fear. All right. So those are our same side interior. We've done both the interior sets. Let's do the exterior sets. You want to do alternate first or same side first?
Alternate.
That's what everybody says. alternate exterior angles.
Got him. I know we did this yesterday. Why are you writing this down? I tried to tell you. Jenna, I need angles that are alternate, meaning they're on opposite sides of the transversal, and they're also on the exterior. So here's an example. Angle 1 and angle 7. They're on alternate sides of the transversal, and they're exterior. 2 and 8, yep. Now you might say, wait a minute, 1 and 2 are on opposite sides, and they're also on the exterior. What the heck, right? But 1 and 2 could be better described by linear pair, right? Okay. Now we gotta do same side. We'll do it in light green. Same side, SS, exterior, angles. Diana, I need angles that are on the same side and the exterior. So an example might be angle 1 and angle 8. They're on the same side, the left side, and they're on the exterior. Very good. Ellison. It's your frickin' name, that's what it is. Start a GoFundMe for all the kids that need glasses. What? There's lots of linear pairs. I just didn't want to write them down, because writing down is dumb. Nerd. All right. There she is. Take a picture, right? Be way better than writing them all down this whole time.
Can I just share this video with the whole class?
The video? Why wouldn't you?
Because it's funny and she took my phone. It's really funny.
Oh, it's a video of Ellie?
Yeah.
Nah. All right, enough. So, let's do some theorems.
Wait.
You taking a picture?
Yup.
All right. Let's talk about some theorems. Well, first off, we're going to start with a postulate. Yeah, I'll just do this. Corresponding angles postulate, cap, remember that? It's red. Remember that poor kid? If the two lines are parallel, then the resulting corresponding angles are congruent. So if we have two parallel lines, like we do's, then the resulting corresponding angles are going to be congruent. So 1 and 5 are corresponding, so they're going to be congruent by corresponding angles postulate, cap. Okay? No. Alternate, don't do it. Pay attention. Alternate interior angles theorem. If the lines are parallel, then the resulting alternate interior angles are congruent. Well, we know which ones are alternate interior. 3, 5, 4, and 6. They're going to be congruent by alternate interior angles theorem. Now, it's a theorem, which means we should be able to prove it. You're allowed to use two things, or three things, I should say. You're allowed to use vertical angles. Let's do it in a minty green. How about that? Vertical angles theorem. You're allowed to use corresponding angles postulate. And you're allowed to use linear pair theorem. Okay, let's walk through what these three are. Vertical angles. Who can give me an example of vertical angles? Right? Go ahead, Bailey. All right, Bailey's kidding. She's not funny, though. Ellie, give us an example of vertical angles.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, somebody tell Ellie what it means. One and three. Thank you, Ellie. Speak up next time. One and three are vertical angles. Scissor theorem, right? Your word's not mine. One and three are always congruent no matter what. Doesn't matter if these lines are parallel or not. Does not matter. Two and four are vertical as well, right? Okay, so you're allowed to use that to prove angles are congruent. You're allowed to use corresponding angles postulate to prove that the corresponding angles are congruent, like one and five and two and six and three and seven and four and eight, okay? You're also allowed to use linear pair theorem, not to say they're congruent,
but to say that they are supplementary, right? Okay, so those are your three tools you have to prove alternate interior angles theorem. The theorem says, if they're parallel, they are. Okay, wonderful, you don't have to prove that. The resulting alternate interior angles are congruent. So how do we prove that alternate interior angles are congruent? Well, first of all, give me an example of an alternate interior angles. Bailey?
3 and 5.
3 and 5. So we're gonna focus on 3 and 5. Using this diagram, prove that 3 and 5 are congruent. All you're given is that the lines are parallel, okay? And you have vertical angles theorem in your toolbox, corresponding angles postulate in your toolbox, and linear pair theorem in your toolbox. Remember, vertical angles theorem is saying 1 and 2 are congruent, right? Corresponding angles postulate is telling you that these guys are congruent. And linear pair theorem is telling you that these guys add up to 180, right? So prove that 3 and 5 are congruent. Work together. Yes, ma'am.
I have a question about the rotating rail.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get in here.
Good start. Good start.
Thursday.
Good start. Go up Thursday. Yeah, yeah.
But if I do bad on it, does it go in the grade book as a 0?
You can't do worse. It's impossible. You only have to do the ones you didn't miss or you missed.
Oh.
Yeah. Where you been? Also, if you miss a question by only a half of a point, you get that point for free just by coming in to retake it.
Wow.
You literally are guaranteed a higher grade every time.
Okay. And like, if I still don't do very well, like, it doesn't go in as a
yes.
Zero?
No, it goes in for the grade you get. What?
Well, right now, like, I'm missing
it. Oh, got it. So it is a 0 currently? Yeah, you got to get above a 65, otherwise it will be a 0 still. Yes. Why would that change?
Yeah, the quarter.
How long is the quarter? 7 weeks?
Friday,
is it 7 weeks, 8 weeks?
It's like 9.
Maybe even 9. Yes, it is ending soon. But don't focus on the future, focus on the past. You had 8 weeks. We had the test like 3 weeks ago.
I know,
and I feel you. I'm not like arguing with that. I'm just saying, like, you either do it or you don't, you know? I don't know. If you can't, you can't, right? So given that the lines are parallel, how can we prove, what angle did you choose? Angle 3 and 5. Hello. Oh. Dunk it. Close enough. All right, thank you. Bye. She doesn't want you. Did you win the longest hair competition?
No.
That's the only thing you got going for you.
I know.
Come on, man. If you're going to be good at one thing, be the best. All right. How do we prove 3 and 5 are congruent? How do we prove it? What we don't get done is your homework. I bet you'd like an example.
Ellie!
Stop being a terrible person. I don't mean just the desk thing, I mean like in general. Get your life together. 3 and 5! Ellie! All right, if she does that, you both can just, like, harass her as much as you want. Okay. What? What are you going to do? Yeah. 3 and 5, how do we prove them congruent? Think outside the box a little bit. Forget about 5. What do we know about 3 and 7?
Corresponding.
So 3 and 7 are congruent by corresponding angles postulate. Let's write that down. So 3 is congruent to angle 7 by cap.
Wait, is it not to write this stuff down? I can't do this. Are you not to write this stuff down? Am I supposed to?
Anything we don't get done, you have to do for homework. But if we get it done, you didn't need to write it down. Quinn, true words have never been spoken. All right, 3 and 7 are congruent by corresponding angles postulate. You dig?
Yeah.
Okay, now, great. We want to get 3 and 5 together. We have 3 and 7 together. What do we know about the relationship between 7 and 5? Boom! 7 is congruent to 5 by vertical angles, which was one of the things we were allowed to use, right? We have 3 of them. So now, what's the final blow? 3 is congruent to 5. How do I know that? By? Nope. Substitution. You're allowed to use the basic ones too, like addition, property, and all that stuff. Okay? I'm just saying these are the new ones you can use. Here's why. Let me show you. So Macy, once you're done writing, eyes up here. 7 is the same thing as 5. Okay? They're interchangeable is what that means, right? Once we know they're the same thing, they're interchangeable. See how up here I had 3 is 7? Well, I substituted 7 for 5. Because they're interchangeable. Let me say it again. 3 and 7, right? I just learned by vertical angles theorem that 7 is the same thing as 5, right? It means they're interchangeable. So wherever I see a 7, I can switch it out for a 5, or a 5, switch it for a 7. It's all good. Well, up here I had 3 and 7. I want 3 and 5. Well, if I know 5 and 7 are interchangeable, just switch out the 7 for a 5. And that's what I did. We call that substitution. We're catching you up because that was the week you missed, and you missed this quiz, right? It's okay. So 3 is congruent to 5. So we just proved that alternate interior angles are always congruent if the lines are parallel. That's alternate interior angles theorem. You just proved it. There it is. Ta-da! What about same side interior angles? Give me an example, Diana, of same side interior angles. Three and six are same side interior. 3 and 6. They're not congruent. What do you think they are? Prove it. Prove they're supplementary. You need to get a statement that says 3 and something else are supplementary, and then switch that out for 6.
Can I tell you what right now?
Do it.
3 and 4
are supplementary by what? What tells you they're supplementary? Linear pair theorem. Nope.
Interior something.
No, they're not. Same side interior, that's great, but we can't use that. 4 and 8, though. What does cap stand for?
Corresponding angles.
Corresponding angles. So 4 and 8 are corresponding, which means they're the same. So 3 plus 4 is 180. 4 and 8 are the same. So 3 plus 8 must be 180.
Huh?
Right?
Yeah.
No. That's true. Boom! There we go. We brought it home. So 3 and 6 must add to be 180. Well done. So I need you to prove that. She just did. Watch the video. Hi. Also, you need to prove alternate exterior angles theorem. Well, what's that theorem? Well, what do you think? Alternate exterior angles. Let's find some. Like angle 1 and angle 7. Congruent, supplementary, complementary. What do you think they're going to be? Good. Wonderful. Whatever you thought, great. Prove it. And if you can't, then you thought wrong. They would be. Well, we don't know that yet. What I would do is I would say 1 is the same as 5 because of cap, right? Corresponding angles. Pause just for a second. Stop what you're thinking. You're off on the wrong track. Watch me. 1 and 5 are the same by corresponding angles, right? And 5 and 7 are the same by vertical. So 1 and 7 are the same. Watch me. 1 is 5, 5 is 7, so 1 is 7. Yeah, see what I'm saying? Now, the reason why, corresponding, vertical. Okay, therefore 1 is 7. By substitution, right? That's cool. I also need you to prove same side exterior. What's an example of same side exterior? How about 2 and 7? Are they going to be congruent? Are they going to be complementary, supplementary? What is it? Best of luck. I also have this for you.
Oh my God.
It's not due tomorrow. This is due at the end of Wednesday.
Yeah.
Take a gander. I figured you'd rather have 2 days to work harder than one, right? Isn't that nice? I did.
If I don't show up to school tomorrow.
Yeah, wouldn't you rather have 2 days to work on it instead of one? I could have just given it to you tomorrow.
I have like a whole 2 weeks.
Yeah, but Diana, you did, and you haven't done anything during that time.
I don't even know what the homework is, but it's fine. Someone else.
Prove the other theorems. Oh no. Macy wasn't even here, and she sort of got this. Good. I didn't know.